Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Van. Happy birthday to you.
You ain't nothing but a...
Talk about what Vale has taught us.
One thing Vale has taught me was...
to be on time.
You've taught me to be on time.
And be on time.
I know from you to be very early for things, actually.
Something Vale taught me, super important, was to not drink underage. And I'm happy to report that in the 7 years since, I haven't done it.
Nice, because you're 20, I get it.
Yeah.
Dad has taught me a lot of small things, like always wear your seatbelt.
And he taught me how to use a toaster to toast a bagel.
And he taught me how to use a toaster and toast a bagel.
Leftover mac and cheese is really good with when you mix it with tomato soup. Yeah, it is.
One of the things that Vale has taught me is a lot about how to fix things around the house and how to do things around the house.
Vale has taught me, which unfortunately he never taught you,
ooh,
how to deliver a well-timed joke.
It's hurtful. It's hurtful. I'm not saying it's false, it's just hurtful.
He's taught me to be kind to others. I have a lot of memories of pulling over on the side of the road and helping people, or moving animals off the side of the road because, like, specifically turtles, I think.
One memory I have with Vale is...
it's taking, letting it be okay to take a shower outside at the beach.
The secret toilet. And the white Bahama bathing suit.
It's always okay to take a shower outside.
That was not exactly waterproof. Put it that way.
Push me on the swing and play hide and go seek. Make dinner.
Loved going to meeting every Sunday. That's a memory that sticks out of my mind as a kid.
So a memory I have, I'm going to tell from childhood. We're in a bookstore, and I take forever to make decisions, and I didn't know what book to buy. He was probably looking at different books for a very, very long time. He was, like, trying to help and was picking out books. I was like, how about this one, Rach? How about this one? Finally, he picked one out, and the first line was something along the lines of, like, my name is Rachel, and I'm a teenager. And he was like, oh my god, you have to get this book because the character's name is Rachel. And he, like, ushered me to the checkout line. In adulthood, I realized that he was ready to go. But at the time, I thought it was really magical.
My favorite Vale memory was here in New York when Vale and Kathy surprised Rachel for one of her shows, and it was so great and so fun.
Thinking about the first time that we went to the boardwalk when I got to come out for the first summer, and how special of a time it was.
Mine is called the I'm Cool, I've Got It story. I was like 10, was playing in an all-star tournament for baseball, and in the first night, first game, I was terrible. I ruined the game, I lost it for my team, and I was crying in the car afterwards, and he said, you know, you belong out there, you know, you're cool, you've got it. And he since admitted that he didn't really know what he was talking about then, but it worked. I was like, I'm cool, I got it. I got my confidence back. And for the rest of the tournament, I was far and away the best player on the field in every game. I just would think to myself, I'm cool, I got it. And I was playing out of my mind. It got so intense that in the championship game, I literally said out loud, I'm cool, I've got it. And the catcher was like, what? And I was like, nothing. And I proceeded to hit a walk-off double. So that is my favorite Vale story.
One really fond memory I have of Vale is the toast he gave at our family wedding reception dinner. Vale is a bit of a polished professional, but then he gave this toast that was so emotional and heartfelt and meaningful. I was crying while he was giving it.
My favorite story with Vale would probably be learning to drive and getting my driver's license. I know my mom loves telling the story about the time I drove with Vale and Rachel, and I almost took out like 3 cars, and then Vale took me to get my license, and he basically asked the driving instructor, like, please pass her, it's her 4th time.
I was a freshman in high school, and a senior was driving me home, and he was really cool, and we pulled up to the driveway, and we were about to take a right into the driveway, and Dad had put a giant War is not the answer sign that he had gotten from meeting. I remember being so embarrassed, just thinking, oh my gosh, how could my dad do this? This is so humiliating. And now I'm like, wow, that was really cool.
Something I love about Dad, Vale,
he always finds a good place to sleep when we're on vacation.
He tells stories about his life. I love learning things about him that I didn't know before.
One thing we love about Vale is when he sings Elvis.
And his kind spirit.
And how easygoing he is.
Jake, because he's cute.
I love your sense of humor and the way you laugh when you tell your jokes.
I love how inclusive Vale is. When Sarah and I had just been dating for a couple months, I got invited to Christmas at the Kaufmans, and we spent 3 straight days just watching movies and hanging out together, and I just felt so included in the family right from the beginning.
What we love most about Vale is that he's dependable and always there to help us for everything. Like the time he came over and fixed our air conditioner unit before I even got home to fix it.
You have always had my back. You've always taught me to be confident about myself, to treat others how I want to be treated.
I love how much Dad values family and how much he wants to bring everyone together.
How accommodating you've always been and always looking out for making sure that we're having a great time when we're visiting, so thank you so much.
The other thing that I really admire is that you put your loved ones above anything. And I think everybody here has benefited from that. I certainly have.
Vale, you showed up at my school with jumper cables because my battery was so dead that AAA couldn't jump it.
One piece of advice we have for Vale in his 65th year.
So this is 65. Big year.
The first piece would be for you to now take advantage of senior citizen discounts.
Ooh, good one. Yeah, there's lots of good ones out there. Denny's breakfast.
Keep playing mini golf.
Open presents on your birthday.
Have fun and travel.
Take weekends away with Kathy. Take some vacations together.
Have fun and travel.
Advice for you turning 65 is retire and buy a beach house.
Treat yourself.
Treat yourself.
Okay.
Be late to the courthouse once.
Be late to the courthouse once.
And that's in this hearing September 10th.
The courthouse.
Just have fun.
Mine is for you to grow back the mustache. Challenge.
Dad, you have taught me to be a better person, and I love you so much.
Thank you for everything you've ever done and all you continue to do. It's much appreciated. It doesn't go unnoticed.
Happy birthday.
And happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We love you.
Love you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Vale. Jack's already asleep because it's 6:54, so... he would also wish you a happy birthday if he could talk.
Happy birthday, Vale. We love you.
Happy 65th birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you for having